Hello, I'm Scott Siegel, and welcome to the first edition of my Great American Songbook Concerts, starring some of New York's most talented musical theater, nightclub, and concert stars. There are a number of things that distinguish this show from anything else you may have been seeing lately. First and foremost, the performers singing for you tonight are getting paid. This is no small point in the middle of a pandemic when virtually everyone in live entertainment has lost their jobs. Everybody wants to sing, needs to sing, but nobody was getting paid, and I thought that was wrong. So I had the idea to set up a GoFundMe campaign to crowdsource some money in order to be able to pay performers to sing. And thanks to nearly 50 generous lovers of live entertainment who ponied up the money, they are the producers of this concert, I've been able to create this show for you with a cast that's been given the dignity of being paid for their talent. Now I should add, however, that several of tonight's performers, in an act of generosity of their own, have decided to give their payments back so that other performers in future concerts who may need it more can get paid, and we thank them for that. Now, the second way this show is different from most of what you've been seeing lately is that this is not being live streamed. Theoretically, we should not have all the glitches and problems that other shows you've been watching have had lately. What you're going to see is a show that is today's equivalent of live on tape. Everything's been pre-recorded to give you what I hope is a smooth, clean, and clear show with good sound and nothing going haywire. That's the hope. We'll see. And third, what distinguishes this show most uniquely is the content. You'll be seeing an amazing mix of performers, each singing one song in this approximately one-hour show. And the songs you'll hear, to a very large extent, will resonate with the times we're living through. They honor the ways in which music connects us, the way lyrics inspire us, and the way the themes embrace us. Now, I'm going to do what I always do at my shows at Town Hall, Feinstein's 54 Below, and Temple Emanuel's Stryker Center. I'm going to introduce the singers and their songs, giving you a little history, maybe a little story, and they'll be in between each number. Now, let's begin with a song that carries a lot of extra meaning, especially now. And I have just the right person to sing it for you. She recently returned from France, where she starred as Fanny Brice in the very first production of Funny Girl to ever play in Paris. The show was a hit. She became the toast of Paris. I think that would make her French toast. Sorry about that. She had already become famous with more than 40 million YouTube views with her sensational impressions. I got to know her when she starred in my first incarnation of 11 o'clock numbers that played at Feinstein's at the Regency every Thursday night at 11 o'clock for 8 months. And of course, she has starred for me at Town Hall and many Broadway by the Year concerts, and just as often at Feinstein's 54 Below. She's a two-time Drama Desk nominee, and she is every inch a star. Please welcome Christina Bianco.
Don't tell me not how to live, just sit and putt. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade. Don't tell me not to fly, I've simply got to. If someone takes a spill, it's me and not you. Who told you you're allowed to rain on my parade? And watch my bell note, I'll beat my drum. And if I fail now, it's an adventure. At least I didn't fake it, and I guess I didn't make it. But whether I'm the rose of sheer perfection, a freckle on the nose of life's complexion, a cinder on a shiny apple of its eye. Simply gotta watch my hogs and drum. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade. I'm gonna live and live now. Get what I want, I know how. One roll above the whole shebang. One throw that bell will go clang. Eyes on a target, oh well. One shot, one gunshot, and bam! Hey, mister. guess I didn't fake it. Had to guess I didn't make it. Get ready for me, love, cause I'm a comer. I simply gotta mark my words and remember nobody, no, nobody. It's gonna rain on my parade. Thank you.
Our next song is quite different. It was a hit performed by a frog, Kermit the Frog. It was written by Paul Williams and Kenny Asher. This Muppet movie number was nominated for a Best Original Song Academy Award. It's called The Rainbow Connection. One critic writing about the song said, "Rainbow Connection is an unlikely radio hit, which Kermit the Frog sings with all the dreamy wistfulness of a short, green Judy Garland." And the review went on to say that Rainbow Connection serves the same purpose in the Muppet movie that Over the Rainbow served in The Wizard of Oz, with nearly equal effectiveness. It's an opening establishment of the character's driving urge for something more in life. To sing this much-beloved song, I'm pleased to bring you a veteran of six Broadway shows who famously, in theater circles, starred in an off-Broadway solo musical titled Songs from an Unmade Bed that brought him a Drama Desk nomination. He's accompanied on the bass by his goddaughter, Emma Vernardi. Here is Michael Winther.
Hey, everyone. It's Michael.
And Emma.
We're coming to you from Lenox, Massachusetts. Hey, Scott, thanks for inviting us. And here's our song for you all.
One, two, three.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions. And rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it. I know the wrong, wait and see. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. Who said that every wish would be heard and answered when wished on the morning star? Somebody thought of that, and someone believed it. Look what we've done so far. What's so amazing that keeps us stargazing? And what do we think we might see?
cure me.
Our next song originated on the West End in the musical Pickwick in 1963. It became known in the United States thanks to a big hit recording in 1965 by Tony Bennett. And I remember hearing that song on the Tony Bennett album when I was a kid, and I've loved it ever since. To my mind, it's a truly wonderful fit for this peculiar time we're living through. So to sing If I Rule the World, please welcome on guitar accompaniment a gentleman who has starred in Million Dollar Quartet in Las Vegas and the other Josh Cohn here in New York. And our lovely vocalist has starred as Patsy Cline in Always Patsy Cline and lots of other productions all over the country. Plus, she starred for me at Town Hall and Broadway by the Year and many times at Feinstein's 54 Below. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Leanne Marie Dobbs. The next song you're going to hear is from Jason Robert Brown's Songs for a New World, the composer's critically acclaimed song cycle, and I'd like to read you what a critic by the name of Scott Miller wrote about the show, because it so beautifully lets you know why this song is in our concert. He wrote, "Every song in the show is essentially about the same thing, those moments in life when everything seems perfect and then suddenly disaster strikes, in the form of the loss of a job, an unexpected pregnancy, the death of a loved one, the end of a marriage, imprisonment, even suicide. But it's even more about surviving those moments. It's about the way we regroup and figure out how to survive in a new set of circumstances, a new world, even against seemingly overwhelming odds." Well, to sing I'm Not Afraid of Anything from Songs from a New World, here is a young Australian woman that I was delighted to usher into her career as a musical theater star at Town Hall in Broadway's Rising Stars. Most recently, she was the singing star for Cirque du Soleil's Holiday Spectacular that toured all over North America. Ladies and gentlemen, coming to you directly from Australia, here is Philippa Lynas.
Jenny's afraid of water. I mean, she swims so well, but still, she's afraid of water. So she won't go near the sea. Katie's afraid of darkness. I mean, she sleeps and all, but still, she
This next famous hit song has a strange recording history. I'll give you just the highlights. It was written to be the title tune of the 1966 movie Alfie, the film that turned Michael Caine into a star. Burt Bacharach and his partner Hal David were asked to write it, and when they did, they first offered it to their muse, Dionne Warwick, but she turned it down. Eventually, Cilla Black recorded it in England for the movie, and she had the first hit with it, although it was just a modest hit. Cher recorded it in the United States, and she also had a modest hit with it. During the year of the movie's release, it was ultimately recorded by no less than 42 different artists, just flooding the market. That's when it circled back to Dionne Warwick, who was in a recording session that ended early. They had a little time left over at the studio, so the record's producer suggested that as long as they had the time, why not record Alfie? Dionne Warwick was still against it, thinking it was a waste of time because there was already so many recorded versions of the song, but she finally relented. She just did it in one take, and then her version was the one that became the most famous version of the song. She performed it on TV at the Academy Awards, and in 2008, her recording of Alfie was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame. Well, to sing Alfie for you now, I'm delighted to present a young woman who has received raves from critics across the board, from Dalbeat Magazine to the New York Times. She's performed all over the world and happily for me at both Town Hall and Feinstein's 54 Below. Please welcome Gabrielle Stravelli.
What's it all about, Alfie? Is it just for the moment we live? What's it all about when we sort it out, Alfie? Are we meant to take more than we give? Or are we meant to be kind? And if only fools are kind, Alfie, life belongs only to the strong, Alfie. What will you lend on an old golden rule? As sure as I believe, there's a heaven above, Alfie. More, something even non-believers can believe in. I believe in love, Alfie. Without true love, we just exist, Alfie. Until you find love you've missed, you're nothing, Alfie. When you walk, let your heart lead the way. Then you'll find love any day, Alfie.
I'll keep this introduction short because the song you're going to hear so much speaks for itself, especially in our current circumstances here in New York. It's a Billy Joel song that I'm sure you all know, and to perform it for you, I'm pleased to break out a pianist who has been the musical director for the Broadway's Rising Stars concerts at Town Hall every summer for the last 12 years. Plus, he was the musical director for the first, now legendary, edition of 11 o'clock numbers at 11 o'clock at Feinstein's at the Regency. And in all of that time, I never knew he was also a singer, as well as a pianist. My bad. So, to both play and sing this Billy Joel classic, please welcome John Fisher.
Taking a greyhound on the Hudson.
As is often the case in my concerts, there's an exception to my own rules. This is a concert of Great American Songbook numbers, except for this one. It's a great song, it's just not American. But for our purposes, I think we can adopt it because it has certainly become as famous here as it is in France. And it seems just as fitting now as it did in France at the end of World War II when Edith Piaf made it one of her signature songs. You'll hear it tonight in its original French version, performed by a star who played Eponine in Les Miserables on Broadway and starred as the narrator in the Broadway revival of Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber's Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat, not hat, coat. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Kelly Rapke.
Tes yeux qui font baiser les miens, un rire qui s'épète sur sa bouche, voilà le portrait sans retouche de l'homme auquel j'appartiens. Quand il me prend dans ses bras, il me parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Il me dit des mots d'amour, des mots de tous les jours, et ça fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur, une part de bonheur, dont je connais la cause. C'est lui pour moi, moi pour lui. Alors je sens en moi mon cœur qui bat. Des nuits d'amour et plus finir, un grand bonheur qui prend ses places, les ennuis, les chagrins s'effacent, heureux, heureux en mourir.
This song is the holy grail for child actresses the world over. The first child to sing it was Andrea McArdle in 1977, when Annie opened on Broadway. Since then, it's been sung by everybody from Grace Jones to Lou Rawls and from Barbra Streisand to Alvin and the Chipmunks. No matter who sings it, though, it's always fundamentally a song of hope for a better future. To sing this contemporary classic, please welcome a gentleman whom I consider my go-to guy because he can sing anything from comedy to heroic high drama and everything in between. He made his critically acclaimed Broadway debut in the most recent revival of the Threepenny Opera. Here is Brian Charles Rooney.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say, the sun'll come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're always a day away. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you tomorrow. You're always a day away. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you tomorrow. You're always a day away.
This next song is from a Stephen Schwartz musical that never quite made it to Broadway. Be that as it may, the score still produced several great songs that have managed to get a hearing and have continued to thrive outside the show. The show is Children of Eden, and the song you're going to hear, which is so timely in today's world, is In Whatever Time We Have. It'll be performed for you by a gentleman who was Tony-nominated for his performance as the young male hero of the original production of Miss Saigon. The three stars of that show were Jonathan Pryce, Leah Salonga, and this wonderful talent. Please welcome Willie Falk.
Tomorrow, you and I will be together. From this day forward, nights won't seem so black. From this day forward, we will never look back. In whatever time we have, we will make the most of time. And at least we'll be
production of Les Miserables was the second longest-running musical in theater history, with only the Fantastics ahead of it. But even Les Mis had to close in London because of the virus. But we'll bring it back, at least for a moment, with this famous song from that glorious score. To sing On My Own, please welcome a young woman who joined show business just a couple of years ago when she vaulted to prominence at Town Hall's Broadway's Rising Stars. She has since had all sorts of success, including playing the lead role of Lucy in Jekyll and Hyde opposite Constantine Maroulis, not to mention starring as one of the three great talents in the brand new edition of 11 O'Clock Numbers that has been a hit at Feinstein's 54 Below and is performed out of town as well. She's a brilliant young talent. Here is Mia Jirakis.
Pretending he is beside me, all alone, I walk with him till morning. Without him, I feel his arms around me, and when I lose my way, I close my eyes, and he has found me in the rain. Pavement shines like silver. All the lights are misty in the river. In the darkness, the trees are full of starlight, and all I see is him and me forever and forever. And I know it's only in my mind that I'm talking to myself and not to him. And although I know that he is blind, still I say there's a way for us. I love him, but when the night river's just a river. Without him, the world around me changes. The trees are barren everywhere. The streets are full of strangers. I love him, but every day I'm learning. All my life, I've only been a world that's full of happiness that I have never known. I love him. I love him. I love him. But only
Leonard Cohen's much-beloved anthem titled Hallelujah was originally recorded by Cohen on his 1984 album Various Positions. Interesting title. It was not a song that came easily to him, though. He wrote 80 draft versions for Hallelujah, with one writing session at the Royalton Hotel in New York, where he was reduced to sitting on the floor in his underwear, banging his head on the floor. Even so, when the song was released, it received little attention. 10 years passed before up-and-coming star Jeff Buckley recorded it in 1994 on his one and only album, Grace, just 3 years before his own tragic death by drowning. The single of Hallelujah from that album was released after his death, and it became a posthumous number one hit. After that, everyone recorded it. Before Cohen himself died, there were more than 300 different recorded covers of the song. In a radio interview in 2009, Cohen said he found the number of covers of his song, quote, ironic and amusing, end quote, given that his record label initially refused to release it when he first wrote it. Well, now it's a classic. And to perform it for you, I'm delighted to introduce two young men, twin brothers, who were in the Broadway's Rising Stars concert at Town Hall just this last summer and have really busted out of the gate. They've been playing clubs all over New York, including Birdland and Feinstein's 54 Below. Please welcome John and Matthew, the Drinkwater Brothers.
Hi, I'm John.
And I'm Matt.
And we're going to sing a song called Hallelujah for you.
There was a secret chord David played and pleased the Lord. You don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, minor, four, and a major lift. The baffled king's composing hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Well, your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to her kitchen chair. She broke your throne and cut your hair. And from your lips she drew a hallelujah. Not a cry that you hear at night. It's not someone who's seen the light. It's cold, it's broken. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Next song is especially meaningful in our current circumstances because it's all about how much music means to all of us, especially right now. It doesn't matter that the song was written in 1929 for a Broadway musical that only ran 36 performances and flopped. The song has lived on because its message is both so important and because the way that message is delivered is so powerful. I'm proud to present it to you in the person of a four-time Grammy Award-winning opera star who has performed, as they say in the movies, at all the world's great opera houses. It's true. He even starred on Broadway for 2 years in The Phantom of the Opera, as, of course, the opera singer. To sing without a song from the 1929 musical Great Day, please welcome John Easterlin.
Without a song, the day would never end. Without a song, the road would never bend. When things go wrong, a man ain't got a friend. Without a song, that field of corn would never see a plow. That field of corn would be deserted now. A man is born, but he's no good no how. Without a song, I've got trouble and woe, but sure as I know the Jordan will roar, I'll get along as long as the sun is strong in my soul. I'll never know what makes the rain to fall. I'll never know what makes the grass so tall. I only know there ain't no love at all without a song. We've got our troubles and woes, but sure as we know the Jordan will
I can say about this next song that you probably don't already know. Judy Garland made it everlasting when she performed it in The Wizard of Oz in 1939. The song now belongs to all of us as we all hope for a better world. To sing this iconic song, please welcome a young woman that the New York Times referred to as, quote, fiercely talented, end quote. So true. She's a concert star who has performed all over the world. I'm pleased to say that she and I have collaborated so far on creating four different critically acclaimed shows, one of which was performed in Paris at the Théâtre du Châtelet with a 15-piece orchestra and an adoring crowd of 2,500 people. With Jeffrey G. accompanying her, it's my pleasure to give you Maxine Linehan.
When all the world is a hopeless jumble, and the teardrops tumble all around. Heaven opens a magic lane. When all the clouds darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found, leading from your windowpane to a place behind the sun, just a step beyond the upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Where troubles melt like lemon drops, way above the chimney tops, that's where you. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh, why? Fly beyond the rainbow. Why, oh, why
I think I'd have the good sense to end right there, wouldn't you? But I have one more song for you that's a little different than the rest of what you've just seen. But before I get to it, I have some thank yous to make, so please bear with me. To begin, thank you to our technical director, Dinanda Klassen, for her considerable work and expertise in digitally stitching this whole show together. And as I always do, whether in person or now via video, thank you to the smartest, funniest person I know. I could not do any of this work without her. Thank you to my wife, Barbara Siegel. Applause, applause, applause. Thank you. Now, as I'm sure you all know, our theatrical community is justly famous for stepping up whenever they're needed for a cause, singing for free at benefits left and right. But now here they are, unable to work. Very likely, they'll be the last people in the American workforce who'll be able to go back to work. They need a benefit of their own. But they need more than that. They also need to perform. In fact, there is nothing more they would rather do. Nothing. It's what they live for. They just need something to live on. Which brings me to my final thank you. It's for all the producers who supported the show by giving to our GoFundMe campaign and people who gave in other ways as well to help make sure that performers can actually get paid for the work that they do. Now, you've gotten this far, so please watch this concert to the very end in order to see and to honor our list of valued producers. Also, when you watch the scroll of generous people who have given amounts large and small to underwrite the first couple of these concerts, please consider this an opportunity to join their ranks and get on this list of producers for future concerts in the series by donating in any of the following ways. You can go to GoFundMe.com and in their search engine put in Let's Pay Performers to Perform. You'll see a picture of me and my wife Barbara. That's the campaign, Let's Pay Performers to Perform. Click on that and please consider giving a donation. Or if you have Venmo, you can give on your phone. On your Venmo app, just type in @Scott-Siegel-39 and give whatever you can. You should be seeing that on your screen now, I would hope. There's also a third option, which hopefully you'll see in a moment, using the Zelle app. If you have Zelle, just call this phone number to make a donation, 212-365-4345. You can use this number for Venmo if you like as well. And then there's the old-fashioned way. You can write a check. Just email me at siegelentertainment@msn.com, and I'll tell you how to make it out and where to send it. All of these options will be available to you to see at the end of the show, also after the scroll of producers, so you'll have an opportunity to get those numbers and addresses again. And I'll acknowledge all of your donations, large and small, so that you too can become a producer of our future concerts, helping an ever-increasing number of talented performers like these folks that you've just seen get paid for their work. Believe me, the live entertainment community will love you for it. Now, please keep what I've said in mind while you watch our final song from the 1932 Broadway musical Americana. The song is, so aptly titled in this case, Brother, Can You Spare a Dime? And to perform it, I'm pleased to present a gentleman who starred as the Phantom in the national tour of the Phantom of the Opera. He has performed for me at both Town Hall and Broadway by the Year and many times at Feinstein's 54 Below. Here is Cooper Grodin.
Thank you.
Thank you, and good night, everyone.